This is interesting. It says list from account, then list to account number, and then it says EXP amount, 5000. Now, I will try to bypass the first restriction where I will copy the from and to account number, from to the to account number, because that is the first restriction. I will try to give an amount which is greater than 5000, and I will see whether this works. Okay. I say forward, there's a response which comes in. Oh, by the way, there's a 100 continue response. I'll show you the next time. You see, here it says, please confirm your payment details. The from and to account number is the same, and the amount is greater than 5000. So the rules are bypassed because it was implemented on the client side, right? And when I say confirm, it goes ahead and does the transaction. If you see, this is a 100 continue. We were talking about the error codes, right? So it says success context here. One is of the application owner, second is of the attacker, third is of the auditor. For the crowd here, these are the three contexts which you will be looking at. From auditor perspective, we need to have a very clear business understanding of the application. Then only we will be able to test it from the business context and the technical context. If I were to broadly divide the attacks into two categories, one would be technical attacks, the second would be business-based attacks, business logic attacks. For example, in this case, there was no technical attack which is included, right? We attacked the business logic of the application where a certain business rule was flouted. So, no web application firewall or firewall or scanner, etc. Even a web application scanner cannot do this. Hence, for an auditor, it is required to understand the context and then lay down all the risks which are possible in that application and then start testing whether this is possible, this is possible, this is possible. I will take you through the methodology that we follow in our company going ahead, which ensures that our testing is foolproof. That is one of the most important things. If we as auditors go and test the application, we find 7 findings. Now the owner of the application will ask me, thanks, you have given me 7 findings. How do I know that you have tested for all findings and there are no other 5 findings? How does he get insured, or how do we ensure it? We can only do it by following a certain methodology where we are able to demonstrate that we have considered all the risks. See, I'm sure that most of the defense areas where you perform a risk assessment, right? Based on which you secure each of your weak links and then audit it regularly to see whether the controls are in place, right? Okay. There are two types of business rule attacks. One is the client-side JavaScript, and second is inappropriate Java enforcement. Second is transgressing privilege enforcement, which is direct URL access or cookie-based access. I'll quickly show you an example here. So we've logged in here as a normal user. If we log out, this doesn't require proxy, and I log in as the admin. See, there are most of the pages are same, excepting create user and view message, right? Let's say I choose the create user page. Okay, it's displaying in not properly. That's okay. So idea is.
It's in the frame. It's in the frame. That's right.
Build that
fishing net
of
yours.
Yeah,
still there.
It is there.
Let me just close this. Alright, so now we are logged in as the admin. We see the create user page. Here we have create user.aspx. Okay, this is the my link. Let me just note this down. I log out again as the normal user. And without doing anything, I just need to change this. Create user.aspx. And I get the page. Okay? Very simple attack, like a kiddish attack. But let us not look at the attack. Let us look at the root cause. Because the root cause is the reason for many such attacks, not just this attack. What is the root cause then? Let me show you something. I will copy this link. I will log out. Okay? And I will paste this link. And I say create user. Is it aligning?
No.
Which means for a public user this is not allowed. For a user who is authenticated as a normal user, it is aligned. Which means there is some problem with the session management. Now session management, yeah, what is the problem in this case? One is context. Second is the resource being requested. Here the resource being requested was not mapped to the session of the user. What is called as a role-based access control. From the developer's perspective, he has defined a user as admin in the database. He has made a new page which says admin login and there is a user login. But he has not tried to link the concepts of session management in that. That is where the problem is. Apart from this defining admin users, we need to define roles also. Roles need to be implemented in the database. Resources need to be attached to the role and that needs to be verified for each request. That is where the problem is in this case. Okay, let me show you another example. Okay, this comes under a class of attacks called the direct URL access attacks. In many cases, you would have heard of an attack called the insecure direct object reference attacks. Now, insecure direct object reference attack also happens because of session management issues. Where the user provided parameters are not mapped to the session. Let us see an example here. Okay, I go to forgot password. I give a login ID, user 1. I say, so I get the question. It says, what is your favorite pet? Okay. I'll say dog, which is in most cases the answer. Then it asks me for a new password. Okay. Again, for simplicity purposes, we've built everything on the same page with different frames. This may happen in continuous pages, right? Now, if I give the password, let me fire up my proxy and I will intercept. Alright. Now I will give the password. Currently the password for user 1 is user 123. Okay, I will show you in the database. Here. User 1 is user 123, right? Okay. Now I will give a password, say test 123. And I say reset. And I go to the proxy where the traffic is captured and I see the interesting traffic, which is this. Okay, this is the interesting part of the traffic, which it says text login ID for user 1, new password and confirm password is test 1. Now, as an attacker, I will just change this user 1 to user 2 and try to see if this works. So I've changed it to user 2 and I say forward. I get a 200, okay, and I see the result. It says password is successfully updated for user 2. Okay, we'll go to the database. Select star from HP users. If you see, the password of user 1 remains the same, while the password of user 2 is test 1, 2, 3. Okay? The problem here is the same, insecure direct object reference. What happened here was that the specific user parameter, which is user 2, is a direct object reference to the database for that row of the user. Right? And again, a very simple attack, not difficult to execute, but it requires us to know the context of the application. Okay? And to know that there may be a scenario where the session may not be mapped. Okay, tell me something. After the user 2, user 1 had answered the login ID and the secret question, right? How did it? Okay, the first step, when the user 1, the user gave the login ID, and in most cases it will ask for the date of birth and probably some other number also, and you say submit. How does your question come in?
Select a secret question from
table. Correct, that is the query. But why does it come in? How does the question come for you and not for anyone else? Or someone else's question doesn't come to you?
Because we have set it while registration. While registration, we have set the question.
While registering, we had set the question. And in this case, when we are giving a specific user detail, we are actually authenticated by the application. Application authenticates us, assigns a session. Assigns a session to us and then gives the question. So once it has assigned the session, which means the server knows that for this session, this is the user, does it require to send the user credential again from the client side, which it did in this case, where we had this? Is this required at all? Not required. But this is what most applications do. They have this parameter in the client side as a hidden config variable and it goes. Because this essentially is already authenticated, the server knows for this session, this is the user. When the client sends a request, session will anyway go. On the server side, it will pick up the session, see that which user is mapped to this and execute the particular task. This is an example of insecure direct object reference. So these have been our experiences using such attacks. And you would be surprised to know that not only small development companies, but largest developers companies which you can think of in India are found to be vulnerable using this, and they not only create applications for public for personal use, but banking applications, telecom applications, airline applications, etc. have been found to have these vulnerabilities in our experience. Till date, we've done in the last 5 years approximately 750 application audits, not only in India but abroad, and in all cases we have found such issues. You've covered all this? Okay. What is the cause? Cause is authorization checks are not appropriate, even though authentication is appropriate. How can authorization checks be implemented? By using this concept of role-based access control, where the developer understands the map between the user, his session, his role, and the resource requested. Once that map is clear, we can easily implement it, right? I don't blame the developers that they don't do it. It is that map is not very clear in the design phase itself. That is where the problem comes in. Okay. So, essentially, from a auditor perspective, from a tester perspective, how do we understand which variable means what to the server? Once we review the traffic flowing between the client and the server, all the get post requests and the responses coming from the server. Essentially, it is enough to review the request going from the client, even if you don't review the response. Because in the request, you will have all the hidden variables, URL parameters, cookies, etc. If you review properly the parameters going in the request, you will be able to identify the context on the server side and be able to audit. That is the idea. Okay, so I will not get into details of these because I have been told I have 15 minutes. So I will quickly get into the next attack, which is a cross-site request forgery, where I will directly take you to a demo rather than explain you the theory. We'll go to the accounts page. Cross-site request forgery, I'm sure most of you have heard of this attack. CSRF, XSRF, also called session writing, etc. Now, as far as launching the attack goes, it is very simple. Even the concept is very simple once you understand the concept of same origin policy and session management. That is all to it. Now, you mark the details that this guy has. Balance is 1150, and so there are two accounts, currents and savings. 1150 and 4000. Okay. Now I will require in this case to launch another site, which is called the eWorld Greeting site. This is a demo application to demonstrate CSRF attack. I will show you how this works. Okay. So this, when I went to this application, eWorldGreetings.com, it loaded these various things. Right. We've got image. We've got the text. We've got other stuff. Now I go here and I just say accounts again. I want you to note this again, 1150 and 4000. Login as the user too, because this demo has been made for the user too. Okay. Here, if you see, the user has balances of 1400 and 6000. Right? I open another site called the eWorld Greetings. It loads and I just refresh the account's details, and if you see, this became 400, right? Did you see that or no?
Yes.
You did, right? Now let me just refresh this again. Okay, and I just refresh this again. See, it became minus 5600. Okay, which means 1000 rupees. No, how much?
1000
rupees is being reduced each time. I just refresh this page. Right. So why is this happening? You will say, I am using the same browser. I will then use another browser. Here also it is reducing, using another browser.